Hello friends, today's video is about iatrogenic zonular dialysis. This is a routine case of femtolaser assisted cataract surgery with grade 2 nuclear sclerosis in which there was no pseudo exfoliation or other risk factors for zonular weakness. Here the femtolaser has done 4.6 mm rexus and 4 chops. I prefer to do visco dissection to remove the rexus flap. I avoided hydro dissection as I saw some bubbles behind the nucleus. Phacoemulsification went uneventfully. After the removal of nucleus, I noticed a thick epinucleus and cortex shell. Went ahead with the removal of the same using bimanual irrigation aspiration. By mistake, I pulled the capsular margin with epinucleus at around 7 o'clock position, which caused zonular dialysis between 4 to 9 o'clock position. This is a slow motion video. I could have avoided this by doing a proper hydro dissection after the removal of nucleus. One thing we can notice is that the anterior hyoid face is intact. I did fill the chamber with OVD before the removal of a cannula. Cortical removal done in other quadrant using low parameters with minimal chamber fluctuation. Fill the anterior chamber with dispersive OVD. Decided to use capsular tension ring at this stage to stabilize the bag. Since the area of dialysis is between 4 to 9 o'clock position, I am introducing the CTR gently into the bag opposite to that through the side port using a lens holding forceps. And the same is pushed progressively. The CTR is seen traversing the area across the region of zonular dialysis. Once the other end of the CTR comes near the side port, I use a capsular access forceps to hold the tip and gently release inside the bag. Single piece foldable hydrophobic IOL placed in the bag. Here, the trailing haptic doesn't go easily into the bag. So I prefer to fold the haptic using a Sinsky hook and release gently in the bag rather than dilate. Removing the trapped cortex after the insertion of CTR is little difficult. Using a tangential motion stripping makes this easy. OVD removal done by bimanual irrigation and aspiration. This is a nice overlapping of the capsular excess margin with the optic with well-centered IOL. There's a minimal amount of cortex at 9 o'clock position. Finally, the wounds were sealed. On post-op visit, patient had uncorrected visual acuity of 6-9. Clinical photography revealed well-centered IOL with small amount of cortex in the periphery. Thanks for watching.